fast. Well, the idea is to speak about cloud computing, but in a different perspective, in an evolutionary perspective. So as how we arrive to this concept today, and to figure out that technology is the only sustainable things that we have in the planet, and how every new layer of technology, it is able to create something that is much better and much better in terms of network humanization. And it is a, and every new layer of technology, it becoming and is becoming a big source of innovation for a bigger cluster of people. The, you are familiar with this. Technology is expanding exponentially, the Moore law in electronics, but there are other evidence in biology, in other fields. So exponential is a function that is part of our life. We have a linear view of the world, so we do not figure out these things. But then if you think about, you see that everything is expanding in a very fast mode, and it's exponential. But it is exponential as just a mathematical figure, or it is a combination of more things? Well, the natural evidence is that exponential does not exist. We are used to see this curve, the S curve. So you have a very slow progress in the beginning, and then you have a very fast evolutionary stage or development stage, then you have a plateau. And then what's happened? Then it's going to an end. This is nature, this is biology, this is not technology. Technology, it's able to rebuild itself in a much better way. And so if you put together this curve, you create an exponential. So every time that as in this planet, we have find out a reduction of return, someone come out with a new idea that give again the opportunity to make another step, another growth. Interesting to say, every new step, it is much faster, much larger, and involve much more people, not many people in this planet. So the technology is really something that is good for human. The research and invention phase is just in the beginning, so it is very difficult to figure out what is coming out from an innovation in the research phase. The thing is that there are not a real practical limit in physics for continues to grow and to accelerate the growth. And the things that all these progress have in common is that this is the strange word here, ephemeralization. It is that all the progress is from material to abstract. It is the only way that we can make progress. We have to use less resources. Someone say that we are now in an economy which we have to take care of matter, energy, space, time, because we have to preserve the planet, because we are a lot on this planet, and we have to figure out how we can stay all together in a good way. So yes, and the only way is technology, because we can squeeze things, and we can help the planet to stay alive also with a lot of more people. And these things here is from the 22. In the 9022, Buckminster Fuller has figured out these things, that the progress is moving in this direction. And no computers, no internet. So how we can figure out these things? Because now we have computers. It is much more easy now to figure out how we can dematerialize things. When we have space, time, energy, and matter, you do not have a lot to do. You can think about with some in some construction, you can say, hey, I can save some material, I can do this in a different way, you can make more computation in the beginning just using your pen. And using computation, you can figure out how you can put information inside. So the idea behind the dematerialization is that you substitute space, time, energy, and matter with information. So if you inflate things with information, you can dramatically reduce the matter, energy, space, and time. The point is that, well, in order to accelerate information, you need computers. in the beginning, well, maybe in he was also an engineer, an architect. So in the 22, you can do some kind of calculation by hand, and you figure out that you can do something much better than before. But then at a certain point, if you just use your hand and you use your brain without any accelerator, like a computer, you cannot go very far away. So then we have substituted this with computers. And with computers, we create much, much better things, and we can dematerialize. So information and computer are, in some way, the alter ego, another universe compared to energy, space, matter, and time. And you can substitute energy, space, matter, and time with computer and information. You can build up. These two, it is like a mirror. I think that there's more universe in computer and information than the universe that you can build with matters, but this is another story. The other interesting thing is that all the technology that we have developed have one direction, the direction to create better network. The first big technology was related to language. Then with the language we can communicate in this room. Then we start to write, so we increase the network. And then we start to use computers and we increase again the network. So, and this kind of concept, it's inside the philosophy or this thinker just again before internet and before computers. So in one direction we want to dematerialize, on the other direction we want to create a better network. And matter of fact, now we are becoming in another kind of species, not just looking for food, we are also looking for information. So we are informavor. In some way, we want information. So most of the time, in the past, in the beginning, people were just looking around for food. Now we are looking around for what? We are looking for information. So the point is that we need to information. So the point is how we can search for information, how we can farm information, how we can build information. So that's the other point. So if you put all these things together, you figure out that the reason why internet was built up, it was a necessity, because we need more computational power, we need a better network for communicate with each other, and we need a better way for search for information. The point is that things start to become more and more complex, because, well, then you have to put more servers in one place in the beginning of the internet, and then you have to put routers, you have to put hard disk, and then you have these things that happen everywhere. So this was not a very economical way to do things. And so it is very expensive, and the complexity was growing exponential. So you reach a sort of saturation. You cannot, no one has the capability to build up his own data center. And for what? Just for the peak demand? For the sustaining demand? For what? So, well, if you return back a little bit on our history, you know, the reason of the big success of the Ford T model is, yes, you can say, well, this is the initial way in which you have this industrial chain and the production was very well automated. No, the big success was that everyone can fix it with a hammer and with a screwdriver, so you do not need special tool for use this car. Same things, now we are in the more or less on the same stage with computers. Now we have this great idea. Say, hey, why we have to build up all the computer for? We have to rebuild the computer in every place and to rebuild every data center. Why we do not move all these data center in one place? And everyone can take the advantage of a supercomputer power, just having an access to the net. So if you have an access to the internet, you can use the computer, the power, you can have the access to a supercomputer power. In reality, we were used to this kind of way to do things because Edison, after that he invented the lamps, the big problem for him is how I can distribute energy, because if I do not distribute the energy, no one buy my stuff. And so the Edison, they say Edison 2.0, because, well, the Edison 1.0, we know, is the distribution of electricity. The second cloud now is the distribution of computing. So, but the interesting things is not just the technology itself. It is how this new technology will change our way to look at the world. So everything is becoming a service. And we need a service economy if we want to reduce the quantity of energy, space, matter, and time. And anything as a service, it is, you can say, infrastructure as a service, just because if you have this kind of infrastructure like the cloud computer, every one of you can access the infrastructure as a service. Or if you build a stack of software on top of that, you can say it's a platform as a service. Or you are more familiar with software as a service because you just can connect and do what you want to do. Or what we are trying to explore is device as a service, or whatever you want as a service. So that's the, it is a big change in the business model. And the other interesting things that is also more dramatic in terms of opportunity is that we start to interconnect mind and machine, human and machine. And this is very important if we want to move through a real not non-human intelligence. We need an exponential growth in connection, in machine connected with sensor and actuator. Basically, when you are looking at this infrastructure as the cloud, you centralize all the knowledge inside this big cloud with all the machine there. The cloud is connected to million, trillion of devices that sense the world, and basically you are going in that direction. So we start to get interconnected with the machine, and the machine start to be interconnected with us in a much better way, and that the non-human intelligence is not very far from. So I've designed here in two ways, the enterprise cloud or human, or the cloud for personal people, and the device cloud. At the end of the day, it is more or less the same thing. It's just for have an idea that there are different ways to look at the cloud, and the device cloud is machine to machine. All the big market of machine to machine, how you can connect billion of machine. And the only way to connect billion of machine in a very simple way, it is to use the cloud technology. So we are really entering in a new stage in which, first of all, every one of us can dress a digital exoskeleton. It is like the armor, the Iron Man armor. You can have this now armor. You can just go there, click, and on demand and pay per use, you can supercharge yourself with a lot of computational power. In whatever area you are, you just need to be connected. So this means that also for the third world and for places in the world in which they have no electricity or they do not have a lot of infrastructure, just if they are connected, they can amplify and magnify their ideas in an unbelievable way. So it is really a time in which every one of you that have a nice idea, it can put at work without having a lot of money for do that. And from this perspective, this is the part of the human. Then there is the other part that we have discussed before that is about the devices. It is a really new world. It is something that someone has said that is the biggest revolution, the biggest invention that can change the world is a sort of revolution like the revolution of the steam engine. And what we are talking about, we are talking that we have billions of devices around that can connect, that can collect data, and then we can reuse this data. If we can reuse this data and we can figure out what to do about the data, we can discover a lot of new idea, a lot of new way to use this data, and the knowledge can be dramatically accelerated, and this is the next stage, and this is why we are talking about to be able to build up a better planet or a better world thanks to the technology. So this cloud things is a real, someone say, a sort of Cambrian explosion. It is a Cambrian explosion because it gives to everyone the opportunity to leverage his own idea And it led us to rethink completely about product, about the value add of the product, about the business model, and about the business process. And if we summarize what we have seen, is that we need computer and we need information because we want to stay here in this planet, in this place, trying not to disrupt the environment. So we want to be conscious about the energy, about the space, about matter. Then we need to be better connected. We want to create a better humanity. And then we need our machine. We need the machine in order to create for us a better understanding of our world. So if you put all these things together, you figure out that the cloud is what was really missing in the equation. And with it, I think that there are space for all of you to get a lot of freedom and to get to your ideas the opportunity to fly. Thank you.